I think most scientists have a love-hate relationship with science. There are bits of science we love, such as solving problems and learning something new about the world, and stuff we hate, such as hitting a brick wall for months straight, or doing stuff we like less that are just part of the academic dance. However, something I think we all enjoy is a good conference. It's the opportunity to visit a new place, to meet new people, to reunite with old people, and of course, a chance to see other people's research as well as present your own. And that's exactly what I was up to a few weeks ago, so I thought I'd take you with me. I've already brought you to a few YouTube conferences before, but today I wanted to take you to the other half of my life, that is, the science conferences. Welcome to SEB. SEB stands for the Society for Experimental Biology, and it was actually my very first conference back in 2015. That was in Prague, and I remember it being very vibrant, colourful, and perfect for meeting other academics. I've always found conferences to be very energising and motivating. It's really easy to fall into the PhD slump, and for me, conferences have always been the perfect antidote. It was actually, in fact, a conference that inspired me to start DrawCuriosity in the first place, and it's also always been conferences that have motivated me to get back on with my work. Academic conferences usually have several elements to them. Firstly, and most importantly, is a chance to showcase your research. You can do this through posters, which neatly display your research during designated poster sessions, which allow you to explain it one-on-one to anyone interested, or through talks, which usually last around 15 minutes. This year, I give a talk in the open biomechanics session. If you didn't know, I study the kinematics of insect flight, and I presented a comparison of wingbeak kinematics across three species of fly. Secondly, there are also exhibitors, usually journals and press companies that sell books and companies that create specialist equipment such as high-speed cameras, respirometers and the like will be there. Thirdly, there are special satellite sessions on other topics such as careers and science communication aimed at the younger attendees like myself to explore our options and expand our skills for the future. These are generally some of my favourite sessions because I find they're extremely focused, very well put together and they really motivate me to try out new stuff. And finally, there are many occasions to get sociable. SEB has always been excellent at hosting plenty of dinners for people to meet and discuss different topics, giving everyone a chance to mingle. And of course, there's the end of conference party where everyone gets together and eats an even fancier dinner and then dances the night away. It is my opinion that all PhD students should definitely take their supervisors to a hard house party at least once in their lifetime. For me, there are two best bits to conferences. For one, I love taking a short break, discovering a new country, trying out a new language, tasting new food, seeing things from a different perspective. And the other is I love meeting people. I love meeting other researchers, talking to them about their work. For example, I had the pleasure of meeting Anna Stöckl, who's done some really interesting research on spatial summation and night vision in moths, or Esther Odekunle, who works on the neurobiology of starfish. It was also great to see old friends from other biomechanics labs, and in fact, Zoe Self and Jim Usherwood put together the most memorable poster I have ever come across. They prompted us to find out whether we crawled like horses or hippos, and if you know me at all, of course I had to find out. And apparently, I crawl more like a horse. One of the more pleasant surprises this year was apparently my talk won third best prize in the open biomechanics session. This was quite unexpected, but a very welcome self-esteem boost. To be honest, it's actually been a reoccurring theme since becoming a DPhil student that I worry that my work or my videos or that any output I have in general isn't good enough. Some might call this imposter syndrome, but instances like these give me a chance to try and change that perception of myself. Overall, SEB was, as ever, a motivating and inspiring conference. Sweden was lovely and a country I would definitely love to visit again in the future. And most importantly, I've returned to my PhD refreshed and energised for the final stretch. And before you go, I've got two little announcements. Firstly, if you like this kind of video and you're into the cool kids stuff, I've actually been using Snapchat a lot recently to sort of cover my daily life as a PhD student and a science communicator and some other bits in between. Those of you who found it in my description seem to enjoy it, so I thought I'd mention it a little more officially here. And secondly, I'm going to be at Summer in the City tomorrow Saturday. I'm going to be on the Science and YouTube panel at 4 p.m. in panel room C. So please do come say hello, it would be a pleasure. And as always, thank you so much for watching me, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.